Monday, December 19th. Gavin. Gil? Oh, hey guys. How the hell did you get in? I have a copy of the key, remember? Wait, that's how you greet me after so many days? I never doubted you'd be fine. If anything, I'd have to cut your paycheck for leaving for so many days without notice. See, Jill? He'll be here on Monday like nothing ever happened. Wait, why does he have a copy of the key and I don't? The need for you having a key never arose. True. Anyway, glad you're fine, Gil. Thanks, I guess. What, are you gonna make me wash the bathrooms again? Not today. Listen, I don't know who the hell you really are or what's trying to come back to bite you in the ass, but remember there are people that actually care about you. Don't just leave like you did. Especially after all hell broke loose. At least give us a sign that you're still alive. So you worried? Isn't that normal? When it comes to you, I don't know. Shut up. She's right, though. You shouldn't make ladies worry so much. Check if the cats didn't move the internet antenna, would you? Fine, fine. Hey boss, why did you leave the hoodie at my place? Because it's yours? But I told you you could keep it. Sorry, I couldn't find it in myself to take it. Why? Partly because I didn't feel right taking it, but mostly because I thought you'd totally look cute with it. I see. Don't think I'm rejecting a gift of yours, it's just preserving cuteness is one of my principles. Right. Are you still worried about the whole bar closing thing? Of course I am. Not like I can't work because of it, but, you know, all we can do is enjoy whatever time we have left here as best we can. Yeah. So cheer up. Clients smell sadness and fear, and we don't want that. I'll go to my office. Okay. Antenna's fine. Did I miss anything? Not really, no. Time to mix drinks and change lives. Oh yeah, Gil? Hmm? Glad to see you're fine. I mean it. Thanks. Excuse me, I'm looking for Dana Zane. May I have your name? Tell her it's Brian. Just a sec. Boss! Some Brian guy is looking for you! Tell him I'll be there in a bit! She'll... You heard her. It's alright, I'll wait. It's weird for someone to come asking for her, though. It's not weird when you're BTC's regional manager in these parts. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. I just saw his jacket, too. Yeah, I guess that's... I guess I didn't give you the best first impression. Don't worry, I know who I'm dealing with. I'm not a fan of people treating me too nicely because of my position anyways. Handle me like I'm just another client. Alright, I can do that. What can I get you, Mr. Brian? Let's go with the basics. A sugar rush, please. He wants a sugar rush, I can do that. 2 Adelheid, 1 Powder Delta, optional Carmotrin. Ooh, okay. We're good. Here. Yeah, this one's nice. Back in training, they made a big deal out of sugar rushes. Why? They're like the fried eggs of mixing drinks. They're the most basic thing, but people can still mess them up. Sugar rushes are simple enough that you only need to follow instructions. If you can't even do that, your future as a bartender is not bright. Huh, they never told me that. You're Jill, right? Yep, that's me. Donna has talked quite a bit about you. Really? And I guess you must have a few questions for me, am I right? Mostly concerning the closure warning Barhalla got. Can you disclose any information? I shouldn't, but you have the right to know. Thanks. Don't mention it. Now, where do I start? You saw the news on the information leaked during the Apollo Trust Bank incident, right? About the White Knights having lots of members from criminal organizations in their ranks? Turns out the White Knights weren't the only ones with shady people. Some of those folks have been trying to elude legal problems using BTC certified bars. The BTC bars have their own protocols, meaning the White Knights can't dig too deeply. At least, not without going through a ton of paperwork first, giving the criminals time to cover their tracks. Although it takes a bit of time to set up, it has apparently proven an effective method for money laundering. Where does Valhalla come in? Young bars are the ones under the radar right now, and the modest to low income ones are the primary suspect. It's not just Valhalla. Any small bar with small income is being investigated heavily right now. So the closure notice is due to low sales. Among the reasons a bar can get axed, low sales is the rarest one. If low sales were the problem, lots of bars would close every year. You'll find out soon enough. Huh. Sorry? Oh, nothing. Don't mind me. Seems your guess was spot on, Gil. Hmm? If it helps, I'm doing my best to appeal in your place. Really? Why? Most of Glitch City's bars are a pain in the ass. They constantly give reports of chemical damage or shady drinks. This is one of the few places from which I almost never receive complaints. The closest thing to a recent complaint was that whole Farmer Fabrics affair from a little while ago. So much saliva. I wouldn't get my hopes up, though. Especially since the BTC will try to save face by axing as many subjects as possible. Knowing you're making an effort is enough, thanks. Can I get you anything else? Now that I remember, the recipe book has a drink created here, right? Oh yeah, the suplex. Give me one of those, please. Sure. Let's give Brian a suplex. Four Bronson extract. Three Flanner Guide. Three Carmotrin. All on the rocks and mixed. Here. The registry form said this was an accident while making a pile driver. You can ask the creator of the drink just over there. Ah, so you're Robert. Yes, that's my name. I'm Robert. The one and only. Joe called you Gil, though. It's Argentinian slang. Robert here is from Argentina, so we call him Gil. Huh, I see. Sorry, Brian, I was sorting some stuff at the office. Please come in. I'll be right there. Any other questions, Jill? Not really, no. Although, yeah? If you were to evaluate my performance right now, how would you rate me? Clean and timely delivery of the correct orders. Top-notch bartender. Thanks. Now, if you'll excuse me. I'm surprised you haven't met him before. I received my training in another city. The regional supervisor there was some girl with a red mohawk. Ah, I see. I wonder what boss will talk to Brian about. Jill, was it? Ah, Miss Stella, what a pleasure. Are you okay? Yeah, just call me Stella and get me a big beer, please. Huh? Sure, on it. Are you sure you're fine? You know Say, right? Oh no, oh no, 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 no. Please don't tell me. Of course, what's up with her? She was at... Oh god! She was at the Apollo Trust Fund Bank during that whole affair and... Oh. Right, that. So she... She didn't show up on the list of the massive body count in the aftermath, so... I was hoping that maybe you've seen her. As much as I'd love to say that I had... Yeah, I figured as much. Man, the air is suddenly a lot heavier. I mean, I could tell her everything will be alright, but that would sound a bit condescending. What does one do in this kind of situation? Maybe a joke? Nah, that'd be tasteless. Okay, just try and say anything. At the very least, you'll break the tension. Maybe distracting her will be enough? I don't think clearly when under this kind of pressure, do I? There was a private eye in here the other day. Eye? Sorry, I'm a bit on edge. A private detective, I take it. Yeah, maybe you'll want his services? What's his name? I believe it was Art Van... No, Von Delay. Oh, that art guy. Yeah, I actually hired him yesterday to look for Say. So you still have hope. I'm somewhere between bargaining and depression right now, and I'm afraid to let go of bargaining. I see. Is he any good? He doesn't look like it, but he's quite skilled at gathering intel. I believe he'll give me answers about Say, whatever they may be. Sometimes I wish I had magic wand so I could solve all my problems with a swing, you know? Sorry if I'm making you uncomfortable. Oh, sorry, no, it's not about feeling uncomfortable. It's just weird. I usually try to say something to my clients when I see them down. And right now I can't find any words that don't sound hypocritical, useless, or tasteless. I'm glad to know you have that much common sense at least. All I can do is get you drinks. Can I get you anything else? Something sweet. That'll help me calm down a bit. Gladly. Let's give Stella something sweet to calm her down. Here. Thanks. Seems you really like Say. I don't have brothers or sisters, and my social interactions are usually strictly business. So Say's more than a friend to me. She's... Sorry I brought that topic up at a bad time. Don't worry about it. As I was saying, she's more than a friend. She's my emotional support. She's someone I can trust wholeheartedly. I'd say she's like my sister, but siblings usually lack that level of trust. I have to deal with high-class pricks of every race and upbringing on a daily basis. They use a business mask to hide anything they don't want others to know, and I do the same. But with Say, I can be myself. I can do whatever I want and vent all my frustrations. She's always there for me, and now she might need me. But here I am, sitting in a bar, making other people do that job because I'm a useless pile of flesh. Sorry about the outburst. I'm actually kind of jealous of the level of self-control you're using here. I mean, I'd be a mess in that situation. Still, would you like some fresh air? I'm gonna take my break and you could use some. Well, for a given value of fresh. I'm fine, thanks. Okay then. Gil, please service Miss Stella while I take my break. Sure, leave it to me. There was a private eye in... There was a I'm not a fan of people treating me... I'm not a fan of treat... Making... Knowing you're making an effort...